Hey, welcome back from the break. You're watching Outlook on your Joy News channel, also on DSTV channel 421 and GoTV channel 144. Well, before the break, we did a little bit of yoga, then we went to talk to a stylist, and she told us all about dressing up. Well, right now, as a growing car fanatic, and there are some car fanatics out there, we all like to personalize our cars, you know, make it look a little distinctive, out of the ordinary, set it apart from everything else. But, you know, people don't really know how to go about it well. They do a whole bunch of things that make the car look a pretty bit weird. So to find out more, to get a better understanding of it, we decided to go see some pros to help us understand customization of a car. You know, talking about tinting, interior, everything, the whole nine yards. We went all the way to Stancast and we spoke to Kels. When you love a product, you personalize it, give it a distinct look that sets it apart from others that have the same product. Customizing is done on a whole lot of products we own, but this is ever true of automobiles. Most car or bike fanatics love to customize their cars or bikes, no matter the make or year of production of the car or bike. Some customize their first cars or their dream cars when they're able to purchase it. When it's time to customize cars, some go ahead and do all sorts of modifications, like adding neon lights on the number plates of the car, changing the interior, changing the paint job, making the cars faster, what have you. We all love cars on the Outlook team, but since we are novices when it comes to car modifications, we went to see one of the pros, Kelvin Kelsquay of Stancast Automobiles, to help us get a better understanding.
Swag on max, got no legs, bitch, I'm floating. Might turn into a ghost, punk, bitch, yes, I'm floating.
Take it off, yeah, going off, yeah. Money been here, the body's in here. I'm bringing
the Stancast yard is a sight to behold. For car fanatics like us on the Outlook team, it was like a little paradise with all manners of cars, the everyday simple car, amazing high-end and luxurious cars that were being worked on. One of the cars, a Maserati, had its interior and video systems customized. In conversations with Kelvin, we found out so many things can be done when it comes to car modifications, which includes audio or video system enhancement, custom paint job or car wraps, and appearance modifications, oversized wheels or tires, performance modifications, suspension modifications, window tinting, among others.
Some clients come in, they already know what they want. When you feel like they're going too far or more could be done, then we come in, we step in. We allow them to express themselves more. You want, let's say, for example, you want to bring this G-Wagon, you want to spray lime green. I'm not going to stop you from spraying a lime green. You understand? I wouldn't spray my G-Wagon lime green if I had a G-Wagon. I wouldn't spray a lime green. I wouldn't stop you, but I'll make sure I add a few features to it to bring out the boost up the look, overall look of the car. So when it steps out, people don't really turn down the car or look down on the car. They really respect the kind of job done. So that's what we do. We allow the customers to have that experience. We call it the Stancast experience. No matter how you look at it, it's your car. You are the one going to be driving it. And you want that ultimate luxury. So we can do this, offer you this package, star lights, rims, bigger brakes, performance, beautiful, beautiful stuff on your car. And when we finish and the customers always come for the car, they never even think of the cost involved.
For a passionate car enthusiast, Kelvin is very careful. From a layman's point of view, remaking a car, whether old or new, might take a lot of time. And we also found out that it depends on the parts of the car, which most of the time are not found here in Ghana.
Every build has its timeline. It is dependent on what the customer wants on the car. Let's say you want, you just want a wide body like the Ford, a wide body suspension kit, rims and tires. We are looking maximum 2 months, 3 months. But if you want something light, like the Yaris over there, we can do it in a month because we have different teams working together as one. So whilst the paint shop is spraying the car, the Starlight boys are installing the Starlight. The upholstery division is also sewing the seats in. Yes, and Fritz is making orders on the phone to get parts from overseas in here. So everything clashes at once. Then we just, you know, put everything together. Within a month, your car is ready.
One might think when it comes to car customization, it's a male thing. But it will surprise you, there are some females who love this trend. The trend in Ghana when it comes to car customization is the loud exhaust. Some do like to increase the speed of the car, and Kelvin explains why the former is a better option than the latter.
Ghana, the trend is loudness. They like their cars much louder.
Mm.
Yeah, because for you to make your car faster, you need to make sure it has the right type of fuel.
Mm.
For it. The faster you make it, you need to really increase the octane level in the fuel.
Mm.
And you know, we have only V power,
yes,
which is about 94 octane. I think Excellium FE-Max is 95.
Mm.
Some tunes can go all the way to 102 octane.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, really, really flammable stuff. But we don't have that kind of fuel over here. So when you end up tuning your car to that much horsepower, you might end up breaking the car apart.
Mm.
So over here, I advise customers to normally do exhaust tunes.
Mm.
Because, you know, we don't even have the roads to put our foot down. Example, let's say you bring, what car is here? You bring that Maserati.
Yeah.
It has about 424 horsepower. You want 500 horsepower. You need that's about 76 horsepower more. You need to take off the exhaust,
mm-hmm,
to reduce the amount of back pressure,
yeah,
going into the engine. So already you are doing an exhaust tune on it.
Mm.
You understand? So if you are the kind, I'll study you, I'll do a feasibility test and see whether you're the kind of person who's always going to put the foot down. Because if you don't do that, you end up wearing the car. Because you've now changed the memory, the brain of the car to always perform.
Mm.
And if you're the kind of person, you're just going to drive 40, 50, 60, 40, 50, the tune is useless. So I stop you there, advise you though, just do an exhaust tune, get rid of the resonators, do an X-pipe, then you get your sound. I've had a female customer, she recently had the loudest car in Ghana.
Are you serious?
Recently, she's in this thing, loudest. And the car was for a very good friend, and she was often to buy, and I was like, are you sure you want to buy this car with this sound? She's like, that's why I'm buying the car. That's what she said. She said, I'm buying it because of the sound.
Mm.
And it's okay. Obviously, that was about 6 years ago. Right now, there are much, much louder cars now. So I think it's for every market. But we barely get women coming in, ladies coming in to opt for such tunes. What they come for is more of like aesthetics, interior, paint jobs, and a lot.
The car fanatics that we are on the Outlook team, we picked a lot from this conversation, especially on what to do with our cars, be it luxury or an everyday simple car. But we had to take advantage of the luxury cars in the Stankas yard and enjoy them.
Swag on max, got no legs, bitch, I'm floating. Might turn into a ghost punk, bitch, yes, I'm floating.
Woo, take it off, yeah, going off, yeah. Money been here, the body's in here, I'm bringing up.
Amazing. Yes, getting to know all that, so you know what you need to do when you want to personalize your car, how to go about it. And I had to take advantage of those luxurious cars. It felt good sitting in a Maybach. Well, that's a first for me, and I'm keeping it in a book of memories. And that's how we say goodbye today on Outlook. A big thank you to the production crew. They do everything on point. And a big thank you to my stylist, my beautiful dress by AUR in AUR Boutique in Osu. A big thank you to Enyimpa, making me look like a goddess. And a very big thank you to the Fitzgerald. They have this beautiful surroundings and the beautiful welcome they give to us every time we're here. Yes, they are venue partners. And a big thank you to you. Anytime you miss anything on Outlook, check out our YouTube page, Joy News. You find out everything you missed out on the show. You can also go to our social media handles at Joy News on TV and find out what's coming next week every time we update you. My name is Najee Doku. It's been a fantastic time. Enjoy the rest of your weekend.